SpaceX has finally revealed what caused the Starship to explode mere seconds into its maiden orbital test flight. Observers were shocked to see the craft erupt into a massive fireball at the highly anticipated event. In today's video, let's take a closer look at what caused the Starship to blow up. Was the craft ready for this flight, or was it rushed? The Starship is a spacecraft that has been designed to carry both cargo and people to the Moon, Mars, and beyond. The spacecraft is made up of two main components, the Super Heavy Rocket Booster and the Starship spacecraft. The Super Heavy Rocket Booster is responsible for providing the initial thrust to escape Earth's gravity, and then the Starship takes over to carry out the rest of the mission. The ship is designed to be fully reusable, which means that it can be used multiple times, reducing the cost of space travel significantly. This makes it possible for us to explore the final frontier like never before. The rocket is made of stainless steel, a material Musk is particularly fond of, due to its relatively low price. Unlike NASA's Mega Moon rocket, which flies on super-chilled liquid hydrogen and oxygen, this beast is fueled with 10 million pounds of liquid methane and oxygen. The new fuel can be stored at more manageable temperatures than liquid hydrogen, meaning it doesn't need as much insulation and is less prone to leaks, a problem that often stymies NASA launches. Starship is intended to eventually evolve into a fully reusable launch and landing system designed for trips to the Moon, Mars, and other destinations. A fully stacked Starship left the ground on April 20th for the first time, and it came to an explosive end high in the Texas sky. With a mighty roar, the first-ever integrated Starship rocket soared toward space from SpaceX's Seaside Starbase facility at Boca Chica Beach on South Texas's Gulf Coast at 9:33 a.m. Eastern Daylight Time. The majestic rocket came to an ugly end as it consumed itself in an orange and white fireball just 4 minutes after launch and 24 miles above the Gulf of Mexico. As maiden voyages go, it was not pretty. The 165-foot-tall Starship upper stage was supposed to separate from the Super Heavy first stage about 3 minutes after liftoff, but that never happened. The two vehicles remained connected, and the stack began to tumble, ultimately exploding or experiencing what SpaceX calls a rapid, unscheduled disassembly. This destruction was intentional, ordered after Starship experienced these problems. The vehicle experienced multiple engine failures during the flight test, lost altitude, and began to tumble. The flight termination system was commanded on both the booster and the ship. But the employees gathered at SpaceX headquarters in Hawthorne, California to watch the launch let out a massive cheer at Starship's demise, celebrating the gains made on its first ever liftoff. The giant vehicle reached a maximum altitude of about 24 miles, according to the data on SpaceX's launch webcast. It was SpaceX's second attempt to launch Starship. An initial try on April 17th ended in a scrub due to a frozen valve. The flight plan on the 20th called for Super Heavy to come back to Earth in the Gulf of Mexico roughly 8 minutes into the flight. The upper stage, meanwhile, was supposed to fire up at six Raptors to head up to the final frontier and a planned partial trip around our planet. The goal was to get Starship to a maximum altitude of about 145 miles, then bring it barreling back into Earth's atmosphere for a trial-by-fire re-entry, ending with a hard splashdown in the Pacific Ocean, not far from the Hawaiian island of Kauai, about 90 minutes after liftoff. SpaceX wasn't expecting everything to work out, however. New rockets often fail on their first test flight, and Starship is far bolder and more complex than most launchers. Rather, this test was all about gathering data and responding properly to whatever ended up happening, company representatives stressed. In the days since, much virtual ink has been spilled, both applauding the launch and condemning its failure. NASA Administrator Bill Nelson was among the first to congratulate SpaceX. He stated that every great achievement throughout history has demanded some level of calculated risk because with great risk comes great reward. The rest of the Twitterverse wasn't as sanguine, with many people labeling the test as reckless and rushed. But whether the Starship explosion was a successful failure, as some have dubbed it, or a failure, period, the causes of the incident still have to be determined. That question must be answered soon if SpaceX hopes to launch another Starship in anywhere close to the few months SpaceX founder and boss Elon Musk promised in a tweet immediately after the aborted flight. Musk's tweet barely had time to go public before the Federal Aviation Administration announced it was temporarily grounding the entire Starship fleet, stating that an anomaly occurred during the ascent and prior to stage separation, resulting in a loss of the vehicle. The statement said that a return to flight of the Starship Super Heavy vehicle is based on the FAA determining that any system, process, or procedure related to the mishap does not affect public safety. Clearing that FAA hurdle will require SpaceX to take a deep dive into the telemetry that streamed down from the Starship during its brief flight. This much is clear. Of the 33 engines that power the rocket's first stage, flight video reveals that at least 8 failed to fire. In a February 9th static fire test, during which the engines were ignited with the rocket anchored to the ground, 31 of the 33 worked as planned. Elon Musk tweeted that the team turned off one engine just before starting and one stopped itself, so 31 engines fired overall, but these were still enough to reach orbit. That may be true when 31 engines are firing, but not a mere 25. Had the Starship's engines worked as planned last week, the first stage would have separated and fallen back to Earth at the 3-minute point of the flight, leaving 9 engines on the second stage to carry the rest of the spacecraft to space. Instead, it was at that point that the rocket went into an uncontrolled tumble that lasted for a full and harrowing minute. At the end of that minute, the rocket blew up. The loss of the rocket itself was not the only harm done that day. The launch pad suffered serious damage as bowling ball-sized chunks of concrete were broken loose and flung about from the force of the engines that did ignite. As the New York Times, Texas Public Radio, and others reported, in Port Isabel, Texas, a city 6 miles from SpaceX's Boca Chica launch site, buildings shook, at least one window shattered, and a cloud of sandy debris rained down on the residents and their homes. SpaceX is not pretending that solutions to all the problems that arose on April 20th will come soon, and after-action reports and repairs like the one the company is faced with are typically slow, painstaking affairs. Many are asking, why didn't the Starship separate as planned? Why did a few engines fail on the booster phase? And what will be done to mitigate launch area damage on future missions? All good questions, and there are others too. The second stage of the rocket didn't even get a chance to try flying. After all, there's no way of knowing yet if there are design flaws buried within it that will be revealed only on subsequent tests after the problems in the first stage are worked out. And if 25 engines can do the kind of damage they did to Port Isabel, what will happen when the full complement of 33 does successfully light in tandem? Especially since even with just a portion of its engines burning, Starship's April 20th flight still made it the most powerful rocket ever launched. For now, SpaceX is keeping its head down, trying to solve its problems, make its repairs, and satisfy the FAA, which holds the ultimate leash on future Starship flights. There are many who continue to believe the company has the wherewithal to do that, and that Starship has a bright future. Elon Musk has long stressed that he founded SpaceX back in 2002 primarily to help humanity colonize Mars. The billionaire entrepreneur believes that Starship is the vehicle that will finally allow us to do that. SpaceX has been working on the deep space transportation system for a while now. Musk unveiled the basic architecture back in 2016, calling it the Interplanetary Transport System. A year later, the name had changed to BFR, short for Big Falcon Rocket. BFR then morphed into Starship, the name it has held for a few years now. Starship consists of a giant first-stage booster called Super Heavy and an upper stage known, somewhat confusingly, as Starship. Both of these vehicles are designed to be fully reusable, which is the key breakthrough that Musk thinks will finally bring the Red Planet within reach. The two elements of the Starship that launched on the 20th, the Booster 7 Super Heavy prototype and the Ship 24 upper stage, were not going to fly again. SpaceX wasn't planning to recover them from the sea. SpaceX's new Raptor engine is powered by liquid methane and liquid oxygen, a combo also chosen with Mars in mind. Both can be produced on the Red Flight, allowing Starship to launch efficiently from Mars as well as Earth. Musk envisions fleets of Starships flying multiple times per day here on Earth, their Super Heavy boosters coming directly back to the launch mount after each liftoff for rapid inspection, refueling, and relaunch. Such extensive reuse could theoretically bring the cost of each Starship mission down to just a few million dollars, Musk has said. That price point would be truly revolutionary, considering Starship's power. It will be capable of lifting 165 tons to Earth orbit on each mission in its reusable configuration. To put the vehicle's broad into perspective, Super Heavy's 33 Raptors generate about 16.5 million tons of thrust at liftoff. That's nearly twice as much as the previous record holder, NASA's Space Launch System Mega Rocket, which flew for the first time last November on the Artemis 1 moon mission. SpaceX has already sold 2 private around-the-moon Starship missions as well. One was booked by Japanese billionaire Yusaku Maezawa, who will fly with a crew of 8 artists and influencers. Dennis Tito, who paid his own way to the International Space Station back in 2001, will fly on the other Starship moon mission along with his wife Akiko and other passengers whose identities have not yet been disclosed. Target launch dates for those two private moon missions have not yet been announced, but they and all Starship's other envisioned future flights are a little closer to reality now that the huge vehicle has actually gotten off the ground. The Starship has the ability to carry up to 100 passengers to the moon, Mars, and beyond, giving people the opportunity to experience space travel in a whole new way. With its comfortable cabin and advanced life support systems, the Starship is the perfect vehicle for space tourism. And with its powerful engines and efficient fuel system, it can carry out long-duration missions with minimal interruption. Space tourism is a relatively new concept and has only become possible in recent years due to advancements in technology. In the past, only astronauts and professional space travelers had the opportunity to experience the thrill of space travel. But now, with companies like SpaceX offering private missions to space, the dream of space travel is becoming a reality for more and more people. If you like this video, you may also enjoy this one, which talks about SpaceX's new $3.2 billion factory. Do you think this test flight was reckless? Please share your thoughts in the comment section below.